All right, in this video, we're going to cover a question that came in about spooling spinning reels. Should we use monofilament line or not, right? If we're using braid as our main line, should we use monofilament line in the spool below the braid or should we not? And you have some options. So on spools like this, you really need to have monofilament line, or you at least need to not use braid directly to the spool, because that braid, it is prone to slip, where the entire spool of braid can lose its friction against the spool itself. This is the arbor, against the arbor, and it's just gonna twist around the arbor and it's gonna be worthless. You're gonna have to take all the line out. It's a huge mess. So for that reason, if you're using a spool like this, definitely do not go straight braid. You basically have two options. Number one is you can get electrical tape. A lot of people do that. I personally don't, but a lot of people just put electrical tape around the arbor. That way that tape has a bunch of glue in there and it'll basically keep everything intact, where you can tie the braid on top of the tape and then spool it up from there. I don't do that. What I do is I just use some monofilament line. This is the foolproof way that is guaranteed to never slip. I have heard situations where over a long period of time that the tape can lose its friction and you can have the same problem. But also the reason why I like monofilament line is that I use 10 pound line most of the time, 10 pound braid. And with a 2,500 to 3,000 spool, it'll hold like 200 yards or more of line in many cases. And I just don't even need that. I don't need that much line, right? For inshore fishing, you don't need that much. Like 100 to 150 yards is plenty. And so what I like to do, just to save money, is spool the base of it with monofilament line. It's much less expensive per yard. The diameter's thicker as well, so you can fill up a good amount of the spool with the much less expensive line, and then do a line to line knot, and then fill up the last, I try to do 100 to 150 yards of braid on the top shot. So that way, on my future re-spools, if I get 150 yard line, spool of line, then it's just gonna be one serving each. Or if I get a 300 yard spool, I know that I can get at least, you know, two spools out of that one, two re-spools out of that one spool. And if you are gonna use mono, it doesn't have to be a certain size. So I use 10 pound braid in most cases, and I prefer to use 10 pound mono, but sometimes I go up, this is 14, and this works just fine. And that's why we added this to our shop, our online tackle store. We do have mono on here. This is the least expensive mono that we found that's in a small spool, and that'll cover a good amount of re-spools. All you need, you just have to do it once for every new reel. I basically just get a baseline of mono and I leave it there. I leave it there forever. So on future re-spools, I keep that same monofilament line there, and I just retie the new braid to the old mono. And the fact that the mono is down there deep, I haven't had any issues with it going bad. That's just the way that I've been doing it. So long story short, just make sure to not use your braid directly onto the spool. Even those braid-ready spools can be at risk. And so even on braid-ready spools, where they have that little rubber gasket around there, I still use the monofilament line. Again, it guarantees that it'll never slip, and it'll help me just save money, where I can use the much less expensive line on the very bottom, the part that never really sees the light of day, and I just leave it there forever, and that way, again, can save a lot of money. So that's it for now. Leave a question down below if you have any. And if you're new to Salt Strong, just know that we're the online fishing club that'll help you catch more fish than ever before while saving money on all the tackle you need. To learn more, go to saltstrong.com. Otherwise, hope to see you again soon. There's something about the water that'll give you peace all by yourself or with your family. Live Salt Strong and wet alone.